237 times 564. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits. We need 6 spots in our box. So I have to make it a little bit bigger, because I'll need a box for the 2 and the 3 and the 7. And I'll need a box for the 5, the 6, and the 4. We're not going to use either of the corners. This diagonal, here's the next diagonal. This is the ones column, the tens, the hundreds, the thousands, the 10,000s, and the 100,000s. Now we're going to multiply. 2 hits the 5 in this box. 2 times 5 is 10. 3 and 5 intersect here at 15. 7 hits the 5 at 35. This box is the 2 joined with the 6. 2 times 6 is 12. 3 times 6, 18. 7 times 6 is 42. 2 times 4 intersect in this box, the 2 and the 4, is 8. That's a single digit number, so I'm going to put it on as 08. 3 hits 4 at 12, and 7 times 4 is 28. The first diagonal into the ones column, we only have the 8. Remember, these numbers get eliminated after we fill in the grid. The tens column, we have 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6. In the hundreds column, gets kind of busy, doesn't it? We have 5 plus 4 is 9. Here's 8 plus 1, there's a 9 combination and another 9 combination. 9 plus 9 is 18. And 8 more is 26. Put down the 6, carry the 2. 2 plus 3 is 5, 5 and 5 is 10. Here's 11, 13. Put down the 3, we're going to carry the 1 to the 10,000s column. 1, 2, and 3. And our lone 1. So the answer to this problem is 133,668. As I mentioned before, each of these techniques have their pros and their cons. So you're going to familiarize yourself with them and then perhaps choose the one that best works for you.